So one of the innovations we developed here in our 3D clinical applications team was the 3D printed nasopharyngeal swab, which was used for COVID diagnostic testing.
My interest in research actually initially was in an entirely different area, and kind of by accident discovered a test for predicting preterm birth. That led to many, many questions in my mind about what caused preterm birth and could we develop better strategies for preventing it.
We focus on cellular and molecular mechanisms of Alzheimer's disease, trying to find a cure, find a way to delay the onset of the disease or slow the progression of the disease.
About 90%, 95% of all our funding is from the National Institutes of Health. Over my years here at USF, that's, you know, well in excess of $500 million. Tens of millions of dollars as well now from industry and from private foundations.
The vision that I brought here was to create a department that had within it centers of excellence across the major domains of neurology dedicated to finding new treatments for previously incurable diseases.
There's really nothing that we can't achieve if we really focus on working together. So we're kind of always reassessing, you know, who could help us with this? Who do we have access to that can help us with this patient? And making sure that every single member of that team is valued.
This type of program, as cardiogenetics, is not something to be done by a single person or a single group. You really do need a team.
That's one thing that I'm trying to do as Associate Dean for Neuroscience is to build bridges between divisions, departments, and different fields of research.
USF is a place where people can come and enter a very collaborative environment that not only embraces collaboration, but also embraces innovation and thinking of new ways to do things. If you can conceptualize it and funding can be found to do some of it, the answer is yes. We will do it, we will try it. Most recently, Dr. Jerry Edwards, who's one of our researchers in Alzheimer's disease here, managed to get a $40 million NIH grant for the study of Alzheimer's disease. And it's going to yield huge insights going forward that are going to be very important for us for further understanding not only the disease, but its full impact on the patients.
I think what we practice here at USF is being a learning organization, never being satisfied with where we are right now and knowing that there's a way to do better.
We started out small. We started out with one printer, but based on getting the research behind how to validate the technology, we've been able to show that it works and that we can do this accurately.
I think part of the rapid ascent of the university and rapid ascent of the medical school has been the willingness to take chances, to learn from your mistakes, but to keep moving forward.
One of the things I learned here at my training at USF was to be able to be creative and think outside the box. We've been able to say, just because it's done that way doesn't mean that we have to keep doing it that way. Maybe there's a new approach that we haven't looked at.
We are after the goal not only of caring for our patients clinically, but curing these terrible diseases and literally eliminating them from the face of the earth. We've had tremendous success recruiting some of the top minds over the last decade to USF and have created really a powerhouse research institution here.
My name is Dr. Summer Decker.
My name is Charles Lockwood.
My name is Gopal Tinakaran.
My name is Jeffrey Krischer.
I'm Tom McDonald.
I'm Dr. Clifton Gooch.
I'm Dr. Terry Ashmead.
I tell my people that they need to be engaged in something they can really believe in and really take home with them. And I've been fortunate I found that group of people here. It's been a pleasure to work with them, and you know, along the way we've made some amazing discoveries that really have impacted on people's lives.